Putting it simply, digital health is about using technology to improve people's health.
I think there's many different aspects that you could explore looking at digital health.
I think it goes way, way beyond the facts of having an electronic record.
To me, it's about integrating all sorts of aspects of electronics, computer science, perhaps mathematics, materials.
It's websites and apps to support people.
It would harness modern technology in a very positive sense.
Using artificial intelligence and machine learning to
personal health devices that help with monitoring.
So it's the ultimate collaborative effort, I suppose.
So that's for me digital health, using digital technologies to improve health.
Now, who wants to go first?
Be my guest. So it's estimated that 1-2% of the population will have the bipolar disorder condition. There are many different drugs that people take. Lithium is the drug of choice, but lithium has a very narrow therapeutic range to keep it effective and to keep it safe.
Currently, the NHS spends £10 billion a year on the treatment of diabetes. For me, what's special about the Beat Diabetes service is that we are providing online support for people living with type 2 diabetes, but sitting behind those websites are health coaches. There are real people.
For a diabetic, it's something that has the potential to be life-changing. I can only get to see my diabetic nurse twice a year for probably less than 20 minutes now. This could be transformational. It's a game-changing thing to do.
When you go back to medical textbook in the 1890s, William Harvey, he actually already stated that a man is just as old as his blood vessels. We don't really know how this translates into disease development. Opening this black box of the microcirculation could help us identify problems that could cause a problem in the future. The problem is that all these machines you see here, the ultrasound machine, catheterization machine, all of those can only tell you something about blood vessels that are this big. And the ones I'm talking about in this project are this big.
So we were looking at miniaturizing a sensor for lithium, some type of wearable, either garment or perhaps a bandage or a patch.
So the patch would be able to measure the concentration of lithium either periodically or constantly, and you'd be able to just tap your phone to get the information there. And you can miniaturize it further. We're really concentrating on paring them down to the absolute minimum without damaging the quality of the data or the complexity of the functionality.
So in the context of our microvascular research, that is a technology with which you can essentially look in 4D through the skin and look at individual blood vessels. So the resolution goes down to 5 micrometers, which is smaller than a red blood cell. We will be able to essentially put it at the tip of a needle.
The Beat Diabetes program gives you that support of others going through the same thing, that ability to interact with other people and know that they're struggling as well and that they're having the same problems. And technology is one of the easiest ways you can do that today.
We're drawing on peer support as well, because to make any kind of lifestyle change, you need to support the person's psychological well-being. Otherwise, that's not going to happen.
And the thing is, you've got 20 people in a group. They're giving you 20 ideas. We've been sharing the meals we're cooking and taking pictures of them.
The University of Surrey, the atmosphere and the research culture is very open, just like this hospital. One of the reasons for creating this unique joint appointments between NHS trusts and the university is to put knowledge that is created by engineers, by physicists, by biologists into the clinical world.
So the University of Surrey, they really want to help develop people, and I think as well foster good science.
You're learning from the absolute experts by working together on something that has never been seen before.
A synergy can happen, that something totally new will emerge out of that neither had envisioned before that.
A large number of very friendly, very smart people see their work as part of a bigger vision.
How will you change the world by doing something completely new? And I think we're developing a reputation for doing this. So to me, it's very exciting that it can open up a range of possibilities.
cardiovascular problems, cancer, all of those conditions would benefit from a slightly different version of what's being delivered here.
It would be truly amazing if we could look at large-scale manufacturing of electrodes and readers that could be used routinely in psychiatry.
Digital health is a new, exciting, emerging field at the University of Surrey.
I'm Christian Heiss.
I'm Radu Sporea.
My name's Lynn Smith.
I'm Carol Crean.
My name's John Phillis.
And my name's Debbie Cook.
So I'm Joe Arms.
I'm a senior lecturer in electrical and electronic engineering.
I'm a professor of cardiovascular medicine at the University of Surrey.
Senior lecturer in physical and materials chemistry.
I'm an academic at the University of Surrey and I'm the evaluation lead for the Beat Diabetes Service.
I'm reader for cancer care and I'm the champion for digital health at the University of Surrey.